Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by raprankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.
Track 4, the title track, Judgment Night by Biohazard and Onyx, produced by, Chai Skills? Chyskillz. I'm not really sure how to pronounce
beats
it.
Beats him, I guess.
Okay. Or them.
Well, yeah, beats him. That's right.
Yeah, beats him. Came close, but 6+.
Disgusting. So before I give my rating, I'm going to give my familiarity. I am familiar with Onyx and Biohazard. And funny story. One of the guys in the band, I think his name is Jeremy, he was or still is married to the porn actress Tara Patrick, and they used to get their...
Hold on, this is male territory. All right, hope you can hear the hand rub right now. Hold on, this is... Hold on. Let me tell you something about Tara Patrick, okay? So I had a little crush in ninth grade. It was a girl. Let's say her name was Bamber. Okay, Bamber. So Bamber, Tara Patrick looks like Bamber, right? So one day I got home and I loaded up that what y'all know about that Morpheus, okay? It's like LimeWire, same concept. It's a P2P, you know, it's a little peer to peer. I loaded up that Morpheus. I got me some of that Tara Patrick smut.
We know what that real P2P stands for. Penis to pussy.
It's pump to pump is more like it, you know.
I don't know what that
other word feels like. I've never felt it, but I know what it is to be a pumper. So I was pumping.
Well, Jeremy from Biohazard knows what it's like to pump it with into Tara Patrick, his wife at the time, at least.
Nice.
And they got their prescriptions filled at the CVS I worked at that Craig Mack walked into that one time.
Oh, I remember that story. He's a jerk.
Well, he's a big fucking jerk. R.I.P.
He's dead?
Yeah.
Oh, he did die. That's right. R.I.P. R.I.P. to Craig Mack. Shout out to Tara Patrick. Shout out to Bamber.
Oh, and Biohazard has a cool song called Tales from the Hard Side. I think off the album of the same name, but I'm not quite sure. It's a good song. And Onyx is a dope group, and they have one of my favorite beats of all time, Last Days. The Last Days beat is a classic, and it's one of my favorite. Like, when people use that beat on mixtapes, get a lot of classics off of it. Last Days, Mel. Okay,
is it spelled with the Z? Yeah, it is.
Yeah,
okay.
Can you get that?
I'm pulling it up. Hold on, let me find this.
I want to hear that beat.
Oh, hey, no, a Snapchat ad.
That's not Last Days.
This ain't it. All right, here it is. Welcome to spit365.com, the place to spit all day and work on your flow. This is uploaded 12 years ago. Jeez. Oh, this beat. This from the 8 Mile. He was rapping this in the battle.
Yep.
Oh, this beat hard. Whoa. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We in the last days. I'm in last place, but this ain't a race. I don't see color. Neoliberal paradise. I got a paradise. I roll it. Emotion. Small penis rap over the hard beat. This is the worst raps ever spit over the last days.
I gotta tell you, I told you this last week. But only you and Matt Cardona, formerly known as Zack Ryder, laugh like you're a pack-a-day smoker. I don't think you've ever smoked in your lives. I've never heard such a thing in my entire life.
Mel laughs like he's in his last days.
That's right.
That beat's great.
Let me give you my rating of it. Oh, and of course, Onyx, you know, the hit, the slam, right? Slam! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Slam! You don't know Slam?
I might know Slam.
You know Slam.
I know Slam.
You know Slam.
I hope I know Slam.
You know Slam.
Okay.
You know Slam. One of the biggest Slam guys in the business.
Oh, man. Well,
should I just give my rating?
Know. Yeah, sure.
7. Flat 7. Okay. Bing me, baby.
Well, here's the thing. I want to start with...
Here's the thing. Alec Baldwin-ass dude over here.
So this is the point in the album where, you know, this is a third or fourth listen. Or not a third or fourth. Yeah, it's third or fourth. Anyway, I already heard the album at this point in the car. So I'm listening in headphones, and I was saying to you off the air, this album is different in headphones. Sounds much better. Maybe because, you know, when it was recorded, mixed, mastered, whatever. In the car, it sounds kind of dated. It's not very loud. But in headphones, it sounds great. Mm. Like, everything sounded full and clean and you know. So at this point, I'm like, this album sounds much better in headphones. So this one almost got over. But I gotta say something. So it's been a minute since I've... because especially with these soundtracks, because there isn't much from the Bad website about things like you know, off these soundtracks. But here's what they wrote. I don't know who wrote this, but they wrote, from an era before Limp Bizkit ruined the idea of rap rock. This song from the... And I just stop right there, okay? I'm not doing this Limp Bizkit erasure, this Limp Bizkit disrespect, okay? I'm not here for it. I was never here for
it. I'll just go ahead and say it right now. You know what? I'm going to say it.
Oh, listen, hold on. Let me pull it up. I got to pull up the soundbite because this is very important. I know that what's about to be said is very important because I've seen it for years. People want to act like Limp Bizkit didn't give us Limp Bizkit stuff. So here it is, Moulz. I'm playing it.
You know what? I'm about to say it.
Okay. Fucking, you know what? I'll say it because I don't even like using this word, but I'm gonna have to say it. I'm gonna have to use the word.
Oh no!
Fucking hipsters.
You know about them? These hipsters, you know, they've just morphed. They're still around, you know.
I'm gonna say it, okay? Limp Bizkit is better than anything. Like, his best songs are better than anything on this soundtrack. How many songs are on this soundtrack? 11?
11.
Okay. So, you're not going to tell me that My Way, Break Stuff, and Together Now featuring Method Man, Boiler, okay? Mm. Nookie. Okay?
Nookie.
Listen, I could keep going, you know, like I could keep going.
They got hits. Have you disagreed? My generation, push your fitted rolling, cat rolling, back rolling, like rolling, rolling. Oh,
listen,
come on.
This could be the one just like this. Take a look around. I'm just going off of two albums right now. I'm Broke. Oh, my God. Look, can we get a little I'm Broke?
I'm Broke.
Can we get a little I'm Broke?
I'll give you a little I'm Broke. Let me pull up I'm Broke, you know. They say rap rankings, you're just a jukebox. And it says sometimes.
Fuck you.
You know, you gotta hear.
Sit in front of the computer for 6 hours and try to complain about how we spend our time. Fast forward.
Right, let's see. Where's that I'm Broke? Is it off of.
I think it's Significant Other.
Significant Other. Okay, here we go. Here it is. A little bit of I'm Broke. All right, it's not loading. So let me hold on. It's this is why you can't trust this technology. It don't work. All right, hold on a second. Is this? They don't want me. They don't want me to play Limp Bizkit.
All right, you know They just set me off. Play Break Stuff instead. I want to play Unbroken. Plug the Patreon. But if they don't want us to be able to do that, just play fucking Break Stuff.
Hold on. All right. All right. Break Stuff. Limp Bizkit. I'm gonna have to go.
They set me off.
Have to go. Here's Break Stuff. By the gods, Limp Bizkit.
Listen to these bars.
Who will always be respected.
Listen to
on this show.
These bars.
Oh, not what a Grubhub ad.
What Grubhub?
Is this censored? No, we need the hard.
What is going on out here?
Here we go. It's just one of those days when you don't want to wake up. Everything is fucked. Everybody sucks. You don't really know why, but you want to justify ripping someone's head off.
If you interact, your life is on contract. Your best bet is to stay away, motherfucker. It's just one of those days. It's all about the he says, she says bullshit.
I want to run into a wall. Limp Bizkit. They need to be put in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. That is my opinion about Limp Bizkit. I said it. You can quote me, and that's how I feel.
And they're better than anything on this soundtrack.
Yeah. So speaking of this soundtrack, I do like the beat here.
I like the song. I give it a flat 7. It's good to me because I like this because I think Onyx fits Biohazard. They're a good team up. They're already kind of a hype group to begin with. And the percussion and the energy of this song don't sound that far off from what they'd already be doing. And the addition of Biohazard feels more like there's kind of a rock sample put in the beat than just a real like rock rap fusion song.
Mm-hmm.
So it works for me. There's even like a DJ cut during the portion of the chorus with the guitar. Like a DJ would cut and drop a beat out while a rapper's rapping. They drop the guitar out for a second too. So it still feels very hip hop to me. It's probably the best song on the whole album to me, honestly. And I guess that's appropriate because it's the title track.
Yeah. You know, it's, Aaron hangs out with Judgment Night. You know, it's like it's it almost got over. You know, Onyx coming in here with what I refer to as onomatopoeia raps. Talking about I hits it up, bam, boom, bing, slide. You know, I'm like, all right, okay. I rock with that. I like that. I got to say, Whippersnapper Mel is in the building because I was looking up the lyrics. And I'm like, Fredro Starr, Drake told me about him. Yeah. I know him. You know, he said, in that
movie, feel like that, when Fredro Starr was in Sunset Park
stunting hard in his yellow goose.
We were going to do Sunset Park, but something happened. Wasn't enough rap on the soundtrack.
Oh, man. Well,
that's for everyone who keeps asking me, are you guys going to do this? Well, no, because we already listed what we'll be doing. And if you didn't see the thing you think should be on here, it's probably a good reason for it not being on here.
It is what it is. We said what we said, as they say.
I'm going to feed the cat because it's time to do that. And I'll be right back with America's number one show. America's top rating of rap show that exists. And we're soon to be global. The global audience is going to love this too.
The Rock, he loves us. We represent the global audience.
And I should get a water while I'm in the, fridge area. Gonna get a water.
I'm gonna turn this Limp Bizkit back on.
Throw some Limp on, and we'll be right back.
All right, we're back. The cat's fed. Melvin Birch, that's me, has drained the main vein. We're in good shape. What were we talking about? Onyx? Yeah, Onyx and Daggone Biohazard. Yeah, you know,
Gotta say, I'm a big fan of when they start going back and forth. He comes back in, I think after the chorus, like, yo, give me that shit, you fucking bald-headed bastard. Like, okay, you know, it's aggression. It's judgment night. I respect it. But I gotta say, the final verse of this song, which is apparently Sticky Fingers, is kind of amazing. Like, he was snapping to me. You know, like,
didn't Dan say you sounded like Sticky Fingers on that Rough Riders freestyle you did, the Swizz Beatz freestyle you did that one time?
I think he said something like that.
The bank robbery, that's what it was.
Yeah.
You want to play it?
No. I can't play that. I can't play that. You know, there are reasons why I can't play that. They're looking for me. The feds are watching. I can't give them any. I can't go to jail. I wouldn't make it. So
you definitely wouldn't.
I wouldn't make it. But yeah, he's saying some stuff. I could quote the whole verse, but just if anything, go listen to the Judgment Night title track and go to that final verse, because he's saying some crazy stuff.
Surprised you didn't like this one.
You know, it was almost there. Like I said, that's 6+.
I get the De La Soul one, even though I'm like a huge De La fan. And it's not, like, totally unrepresentative of them. I get the 2 minutes of bullshit at the end being a little off-putting. And it's not, that's not representative of them necessarily. But,
okay,
you know, it's still, this one is a bit shocking to me.
You know how this show works. Things could go up. You know?
Oh, speaking of which, did the Foxy Brown song from last week go up? Well, I guess
I haven't re-listened yet.
I guess I'll find out on I Was Effing Tripping.
Well, you won't, unless I listen between now and when we record part one. I guess you will find out.
Folks, we may have already found out if his feelings have changed on
y'all know before we do. You know, we skip through time. It's just like we're time travelers, but we make sure it's easy to understand for the audience, unlike most time traveling shenanigans. So
indeed.
You know, we do all the heavy lifting for you.
You got anything else for Onyx and Biohazard?
I ain't got nothing else for them, you know. So I guess we can move on because it's time for Mel to get controversial.
Okay.
Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by raprankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.